So ours will be more of a collaborative presentation. And so I call the rest of the team in group four to come here. All right. Okay, so this was the group where we talked about social awareness. And there were two NGOs that were part of our group, Salaam Bombay for tobacco prevention generally, just as a reminder, and Anteshti for organ donation. And so let me start with Anteshti. So I'm going to lay out the set of AI challenges, and they'll speak to the kind of data they have and what can be done. So if you recall, their problem was getting people to become pledgees for organ donation. So if we could predict who will become a pledgee, then we can focus our marketing attention on those people. So that's part of the question. And second, which pledgee may become a donor? Because as you may recall, there are six steps required from pledgee to becoming a donor. So that will also help in focusing our attention. Which pledgee may become an important influencer in getting other people to become organ donors? Chatbot to persuade people to become pledgees. So this is much more futuristic. So these three are things that are much more near term and realistic. And some of this data is already available. And what I'm told is that I've been given some samples. More on the, we have data from the positive side. The negative side data we'll gather in the future. But I'm going to turn this over to them, to Anteshti, to discuss what data they have.
Thank you.
I'll go that way.
Okay, so coming to the first point, usage of machine learning to increase the pledgee numbers. So right now, the data set that we have is having certain set of attributes. That is, let's say that people whoever have donated blood in the past, or college social activists, or existing transplant coordinators. And we can also use Facebook Pixel to remarket to the remarket people who are like website visitors. So these are the like initial set of people who already shown some kind of inclination towards organ donations. Having this set of data, what we plan to do is like in the future plans as to how we can implement machine learning is that we are going to come up with the specific social media audience marketing. Like, is anybody in the crowd really aware of that? How we can use a Twitter or an Insta or a LinkedIn, Facebook, exactly, audience marketing. So based on that, we are going to get a certain more in-depth attributes about these kind of people. Let's say their religious beliefs, their political beliefs, or how many of them really have got interest in charitable trusts. This is how we slowly plan to build the initial set of data who are like probably for sure most probable to become pledgees. Then taking these characteristics, we are going to do market to all the possible audience who are sharing certain attributes. This is what we are planning to do. And like yesterday in the dinner, Mr. Amit Sharma has shared to me about his Learn to Earn a program wherein they are enrolling people by teaching them about the specific program and then paying them for. So it's like there is a certain tutorial and then they listen to tutorial. Once having understood about that, they get a certain mobile top-up money. This is a way how we can enroll the rural people also to know about organ donation. So these are the certain kind of parameters that we can get about data, which currently all the social media tools are providing, all the four, be it your Facebook or Twitter, LinkedIn. So if I get to know a couple of these parameters, like my data behavior, my data's interests, the demographics, so all these data, having got this data about the existing people, then that's how I'm going to get in more and more people into this, into the complete gamut. And these people, so it's like at the end, my vision is to see everybody in India know about what is organ donation. Because if you see the crucial 24 hours, the like based on our field visits, what we've realized is that it's about 24 hours a grief counselor spends in order to get a relative consent. But what if people are already aware? People need not be counseled for telling their, like the person on deathbed for the organs to be donated. So this is what can be done in order to reduce that 24 hours in the complete 6 points that we have mentioned. Yeah, usage of machine learning to improve influencer marketing. So here, the point what I'm trying to put forward is that a pledgee may not really become an actual donor, but he can definitely influence one, right? I mean, if you see in reality, let's say if I pledge my organs, the probability that I die due to road traffic accident, the probability that that may result in a brain death, and again the probability that I'm going to donate my organs, that probability is very bleak. But yes, if I've been an influencer in my, let's say, community of 1 lakh people, if any person gets through that stage, then, and if I'm a decision maker in that relatives thing, then definitely I'm game. So our whole thing is that we should be really using this for the influencer marketing. So how one pledgee can use his connections, etc., to build a bigger group. So one way is that family member connections, LinkedIn connections, customized lists, remarketing, all these are specific tools of the existing social media platforms, which we can use to increase our pledgee database.
The road traffic accident part and the data influence on a local, maybe police inspector, who is first getting an emergency call from a highway and routing it to a nearby emergency department hospital also takes some time. So if something can be done on this to fast capture the data and the condition of the patient and actually get the facility of a good hospital, can really make a brain dead person more propensal to give an organ. So this is what we are emphasizing on in the road traffic accident parts, and the society, like a police officer, like a person who is the administrative head, can be connected through one single loop, maybe a social connection, that yes, some road traffic accident has happened, and at the same time, at the same moment, they are aware of.
So we should continue to move on, if you don't mind, just so that we can keep on time.
So. Okay. Yeah, so then this is a futuristic advanced AI wherein we are continuously using machine learning to predict the success rate of organ pairing and organ matching, improving the quality of lives. So currently, this is the data that we have from other foundations. That is, this is from Tamil Nadu. We can, year on year, we know that how many organs have been donated. But what if we also have the data wherein we are knowing that, okay, kidney A is getting paired with kidney B, and these are the specific parameters. So if it has, if in the 10 cases, using specific attributes, if there were 3 failures, the more the machine learns, that failure rate can be decreased, because we are actually doing a lot of matching with the parameters. So finally, how can we use machine learning to predict the conversion of pledgee into a real organ donor? Step one would be is that we first start targeting the high yield areas. How do we get a high yield area in India if we know that this is the place where a lot of road traffic accidents happen? And then we start implementing our complete model of making every digitally aware person in that city into a pledgee. And then we use technology to totally reduce the time delay of right from getting a brainstem donor to converting into transplant. So it's all going to be a collaborative effort. Yeah, so we just want to reduce the delays in each level involved.
All right.
Any questions?
Let's wait till their presentation is also done. Okay, thank you.
Thanks.
So the next NGO that was involved was Salaam Bombay Tobacco Free Schools, and I wanted to summarize the main points that came up in our conversation with them. So one is to predict which school will become tobacco-free based on some features, because this will help determine which schools may need extra training to make them tobacco-free. They also do random checks of some of the schools because the submitted data may be false. And so 10% of the schools get monitored, and so which 10% should be randomly checked. So this is also an interesting problem. And automatically, because they get thousands of schools sending in data, automatically verifying whether the evidence submitted is accurate or not. Some of the pictures may be duplicates of other schools and so forth. So I'm going to turn this over to them.
Yeah, so basically, we are working towards making schools tobacco-free. And with the limited team and limited resources, we are trying to, basically there is a law which says, you know, all the public premises and, you know, including schools has to be like tobacco free. So what we do basically, there are 29% of the adults in India consume smokeless tobacco. 15% of the youth consume tobacco in India. 5,500 people, youth especially, they test tobacco products first time every day. So you can imagine how vast the problem it is. So what we are doing, how AI can help. Being an NGO, we trust, we cannot, change everything. So we are focusing on the schools and the children's, because the children are the, future of the society. So what we are saying, we'll building scalable and sustainable tobacco control and prevention strategy through AI. So we are working with the schools. We'll collect the data from the school. So if that premises of the school is tobacco-free or not. For that, we are capturing the 11 criteria. There are for example, has the medical checkup done or not? Is there an awareness session is done or not? Is there any board at the main gate? Is there any notice board with the principal's cabin, etc.? These kind of 11 criteria is there. These are the minimum criteria. Of course, there has to be awareness and capacity building has to be done. With these minimum 11 criteria, we collect the data from all the schools, and we work in. We want to do 100% schools tobacco free in Maharashtra, and then gradually at the national level. So minimum, we require a lot of manpower. We cannot afford that. So with the AI. Is it possible to minimize the efforts to check all each and every parameters which have filled by the schools, and there is a lot of manual work to check all the 11 criteria. So there are for example, there are 109,000 schools in only in Maharashtra. So to check every single criterion photo, we need to check 11 lakh entries. So that's a quite challenging task for us. So these are few proposed solution we can work on. So we have categorized it. It is a few are AI solution, and there are some technological improvement solution also. Based on the existing data, we can make predictions. Instead of paying attention all over districts and all the schools at one time, we can just predict what are the difficulties from coming from which kind of parts. For example, if there is a tribal belt and they don't have basic resources to fulfill those 11 criteria, so maybe we can predict that prediction from the data. So we can, our team with the very limited resources, we can focus on those areas, and then can, if time and resources permits, then we can focus on those things. The current training models is a cascade model. There is a transmission loss. So we go to the districts, we train the trainers who are the master trainers from the, all the local, all the block level schools. Then those master trainers go to their respective blocks and they conduct the training there. So it's very subjective thing how efficient and perfect that trainer is to give information and influence, basically. Yeah, and the another thing, it's very again subjective which trainers to select, and there are a lot of queries also regarding the technical thing, also on the tobacco information. So we can introduce the chatbot. There are a lot of calls coming in our office. So, we are not able to log in. We are not able to do these things. So we introduced the chat boards where all the principals and, all the trainers are there. So they can, get the solution right there. This is basically the simple model. There is a problem with the AI intervention. We'll be able to train the trainers, one-to-one, right from the centralized place, creating IC material right away, making it available right there at the app. AI predictions can be help identify which schools need extra trainings or maybe extra IC material and, you know, some extra focus. 10% monitoring, this is again a crucial concern for us. We, with the minimum resources, we cannot cross-check all the 1,09,000, you know, schools. So if we get what kind of rejections or what kind of challenges are coming with particular district or block, then we can, you know, strategize our monitoring system. Then we our impact will be created tobacco-free schools, obviously, and at least for the children's and, you know, at least for the primary and secondary schools, we can provide environment, healthy environment for the children's. We have data available with us, with the schools. We have all the names with the UIDs and the 11 criterias right now. And we can also, we are planning to, data collect for if specific data if needed. Yeah, thank you.
Go ahead.
So your shopping preferences might not be a specific parameter for. Yeah. That was like just one parameter which can be used amongst the multiple parameters, but that might not be used really for the organ donation bit.
Okay, so, yeah. So one but of the reasons I'm suggesting you think about this ethically is there's a general move to not just use all the data that you can collect about people in an unmotivated way as a training model for AI. There's a general idea that this is a bad thing. And whilst Facebook might do it, there's also a general idea that Facebook is not a particularly ethical organisation. So one thing to think about, I think, is to just be a little bit careful in thinking, because you have a very ethical cause that you want to do something. So the thing that I would suggest is think about what are the parameters you really think might have some impact on whether someone does organ donation, and then work within those. And don't just do a really broad brushstroke, which raises big principle questions and big concerns. Does that make sense?
Yes, it does. All right.